is better? Introverts or extroverts, or rather,
introverts.
Another episode of Rika Girly Speaks. We have a very interesting topic today, and as you can see, I have a special guest here, Mr. Innocence. Just as his name implies, he's very innocent. Anyways, he's going to be representing introverts, team introverts, right? And I will be representing team extroverts. So we're gonna find out who is better, introverts or extroverts, or rather,
introverts.
Or should I say who responds or who reacts to situations better? Yeah, that's probably more like it. Introverts or extroverts? Let's go.
If money was no object, what would your perfect party look like?
Parties. Let's see. First of all, there'd be a lot of food. There has to be a lot of food, drinks. Yes, now. there'll be a lot of food, and actually, I don't know. I would have my closest friends there, but I would also like to have like a bunch of people just to make it look like it's a really popping party. Because if you have a party with just five people, it's like, it's like a get together type of thing. I don't know. So there'll be a bunch of people, but then I would roll with my own people, but it'll be really hype. Food, you know, decorations, but mostly food. That's just it for me. And music. Definitely. It has to be music. Yeah.
Well, for me, well, a get together at silly party anyway, so.
Kind of. Yeah, so. Is it?
Yeah, it's serious. So, well, I'll definitely have a few friends also, and maybe, I'm going to say 10 to 50.
Okay, wow.
That's just trying to be generous anyway. Okay, yeah, sure. Again, okay, yeah, definitely there's going to be food, dodo. Yes. There's going to be fried plantain.
He likes dodo.
Yeah, I love it. And then there's going to be music. And what else? Balloons.
Yes.
With helium.
Yes. And then wait.
Yeah, no, I'm going to do that. Put the place in your mouth and try and sound very weird voice.
Yeah. Would things be crazy? Like, would it be like super loud music? Or just calm?
No, yeah. Calm music, chilling music. Not loud.
How was it a party?
It's, okay, you're not like in a very big place, like probably a house party or something like that.
Yeah.
So, second question. At the end of a long day, how do you most effectively recharge?
Effectively recharge? Well, after a long day, most times I just get home, have my bath, provide a new eat, and just get into bed, yeah, and sleep off. Yeah, I do that most times, especially when I'm in school or something. I'm really, really tired.
What? Sleep?
Sleep.
Okay, actually, I sleep sometimes too, but... I'll eat now, like food and a movie. Like, that's the best way to recharge after you've been out, busy. Just get home, get you a nice blanket, get you some popcorn, a nice movie. You know?
Yeah, enjoy. Blankets. In this hot weather.
With your fun, no. Or AC.
AC, really? Okay.
What? How do you sleep? Okay, sometimes I sleep, but sometimes also to recharge, like,
well,
just being around my friends.
Yeah, I get
recharge.
That, but not all the time, though, but also other times I might also get to watch a movie or
yeah.
And then probably
yeah,
sleep off from there.
Yeah. You just sleep. So you don't get, like, recharged from being around people sometimes?
It depends on my mood. I might be in the mood to hang out with people and then get recharged, like, being
from being with them.
Yeah. But then at other times, I'm not also doing the most to do that. So,
okay. So it just really depends. I think you're more of an ambivert, just like me.
you're more an extrovert.
My second is an introvert. I think your first is introverted, and maybe your second is extroverted.
Yeah.
Okay, so we switched. Being in that environment doesn't make you like happy, like fun.
Okay. Let's say we sent you on a retreat to a beautiful hotel in the Alps, but there's no TV, no Wi-Fi, no phones, or people. How long would you really enjoy it for? And how long would you want to stay until you signaled for someone to come get you?
Wait, no people? No. At least you want somebody you can have fun with them.
That's a good part, actually. No people.
No! You're all alone in the woods.
Not woods. In your house.
Yeah, but this is the middle of nowhere.
Not really.
Are you sure?
It's a hotel, so it's a resort.
Is there food?
Definitely. There'll be good food.
But there's no Wi-Fi. You can't talk to people.
That's a sad part, actually.
Would there be music?
No phones, no TV.
And I'll be alone.
No Wi-Fi.
For how long? Listen, humans were made to socialize. That ish. I can't. I'll probably stay for like 3 days. A week, and then I'll call for help.
A week?
Yes. Yes. What would I be doing? Unless there are adventures there. Are there animals I can be friends with?
I don't know.
Oh.
I'll just probably sleep throughout.
What? But that's depression.
No.
I can just be sleeping. I'll get
Wi-Fi. No Wi-Fi, no phones, no television.
I'm saying,
what would you be doing?
That's what I'm saying.
All right. The last one. Mm-hmm. Imagine your boss at work comes to you wanting your very best insights on a complex problem. Where would you prefer to have that meeting? Do you want time to prepare an opinion, or would you rather have brainstorming time with the boss to hash out ideas?
Me? Okay, a complex problem.
Yeah.
I probably want time, because I wouldn't want to turn up for anything without being prepared and start looking at getting this thing.
So you take time to prepare?
Probably take a few days.
What?
Wait, no, it depends on how urgent the matter is for me.
First of all, I want to be my own boss. But I think brainstorming ideas are cool, because I want to know what, because a lot of times the problem we make is that somebody says something but you don't really get the full picture of what they want, or you may not really understand everything in their mind until you ask certain questions, you guys start thinking together. But I like to brainstorm together. I'll go to make an office.
I think that's the point of going back to make your own research first, so that you are more informed, you're more well informed before
you do anything. You want to brainstorm first and then go back and prepare. Oh my gosh. And then return report back to my boss. Because if you brainstorm, you guys are already thinking of things together. So you already have that confidence, okay, this guy has a pretty good idea of, you know,
it's a complex thing.
That's why I need his two senses. Because I might not be able to
do that. That's actually the point. So make research. So you know for yourself what things are. So when you come together, you then bounce ideas.
Are you serious? No, brainstorm first though. Like, if we had an issue now that we had to resolve, maybe something regarding you, I'd be like, okay, innocent. So I'll give you scenario questions and that. Like, you know, let's really know how we can handle this. And after I get an idea, and I go back and I work on it, and then I'll come and I say, okay, give me some time. I'll give you the final answer. That's what I would do, but.
Well,
you just want to really be sure.
I just want to be
before you go to the guy.
I'd love to be prepared. I don't want to just be taken on our way, like,
yeah,
out of the blue. And
how about being spontaneous?
Well, most times, since this is a complex thing, it's good to be prepared.
Okay, so we have come to the end of the questioning. Thank you, background voice. And thank you, Innocent, for being here. Really appreciate it.
I respect my debate.
Team introverts, team extroverts, you guys decide whose reaction or whose response is better. Y'all decide. That's what you think. And it's sad because most of the viewers are introverts too.
Well, big ups to us.
Anyways. It's alright. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. You guys should totally follow him on Instagram. I'll put up his Instagram handle. somewhere at the bottom here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have a wonderful day, guys. Thank you so much. Bye. God bless you.
Bye.
Bye.